This is the Genesis GV70. It's a smaller premium SUV akin to the BMW X3, Mercedes-Benz GLC, Acura RDX, Volvo XC60, Lincoln Corsair. You know what? You get the idea. The competitive landscape is rich with choices, but the GV70 sets itself apart in a few regards, not the least of which being design.
I'm not one to pontificate on style. You know what you like. But in the case of the GV70, I have to proclaim my admiration. In fact, I like it so much, we're gonna bust out some drone footage. Swooping flies.
I've said it before, everything looks better from the sky, including the gorgeous GV70. Genesis's design philosophy looks brilliant when applied to a compact SUV form. I especially like the muscular profile and forward swept C-pillar wing treatment. Here, enjoy a few bonus seconds to draw your own conclusions. Inside, the style parade continues with a bounty of ellipses.
Ellipse, ellipse, ellipse. They're like ovals, but fancier. And yes, I know that's meant to evoke the cross-section of an airplane wing. Of course I know.
The vibe throughout is smart and sporty. I especially like how the climate controls remain invisible until you start the vehicle. The GV70's interior proclaims a strong stylistic statement by shape, tactile quality, and by color. Blue, red, beige, and black themes are all available. Beyond appearances, what's it like to occupy the GV70's cabin?
Let's start in the back seat. I've already set the front seat for my ideal front seat position and, well, first things, let's angle this back a touch. Oh, that goes back pretty far, actually. Okay, so we got some angle. The rear seat doesn't slide, but it doesn't need to. I have adequate clearance in front of my ideal front seat position. Headroom is pretty good. In fact, I'll even notch over here a little bit as I lose my mic pack. And let's see. Do I look like I got enough room? I've got enough room. Let's go to the front seat and see how that works. All right. I mean, unsurprisingly, there's plenty of room up here. I really like the driving position too. The wheel telescopes far enough back that I'm in a very comfortable driving position. Oh, hey, you know what we haven't done in a little while? The Mike Amusio Elbow Comfort Index. So on the outboard, it's a little bit firm underneath this padding here. And then on the inboard, you got the seam and sort of a hard edge. It's a little bit padded, but it could be more padded. I'm gonna go maybe 60% squirrel on that. Hey buddy, good to see you again. As for cargo space, if you want to open up the hatch, you just push this little button right here. It opens up to reveal 28.9 cubic feet, which I think is a very workable amount of space. Let's see what's under here. A little nook that you can put some Genesis branded press materials, perhaps. Is that where you keep your press materials underneath there? That's what I would do too. One thing I like about the cargo area is that you've got these releases back here for flipping the seats forward. Though one thing I have noticed, if you use this one and the access function is working on the driver's seat, the headrest hits it so it doesn't go all the way down. Though in the pantheon of automotive complaints, that's pretty minor. I got it.
As long as I'm lodging complaints, I'm not a fan of the standard two-spoke steering wheel. Consider that motivation to choose the GV70 Sport model like we're driving, which boasts a three-spoke steering wheel along with dark chrome trim, carbon fiber accents, and 21-inch wheels. I also think a traditional volume knob would be easier to use than this roller volume control. Another interface to consider is the 14.5-inch infotainment touchscreen whose distant placement is accounted for by a round control knob.
As stated in other Genesis videos, I like how Genesis puts the screen high here in a very wide aspect ratio because when you're looking at that screen, your eyes aren't far from where you should be looking, which is out at the road ahead. Everything here is controlled through this little knob, and I think the interface is easier to use than, let's say, something you'd get from Mercedes or something along those lines. Though I will point out that on more than one occasion, I have reached for this drive selector instead of the infotainment controller. They're both round and very, very close to each other. You've been warned.
With that helpful segue, let's talk about driving the GV70. Built on the same rear-wheel drive architecture as the Genesis G70 sedan, the GV70 comes standard with rear-biased all-wheel drive. Engine choices include a base 2.5-liter turbocharged four-cylinder, or an optional 3.5-liter twin-turbocharged V6, each paired with an 8-speed automatic transmission.
We happen to be driving the V6 because, of course, we are. Hashtag Blue Book Life. Let's put it to good use. Ooh, peppy.
There's a slight delay off the line, but once that power kicks in, it kicks strong. Besides snappier acceleration, another good reason to choose the 3.5-liter V6 is that it comes with a camera-based adaptive suspension, which reads the road ahead, adjusting the suspension in real time for improved ride and handling.
In my experience, big bumps, even in comfort mode, are met with controlled but firm reactions from the suspension.
Despite the GV70's taut nature, ride comfort is generally agreeable, elevated by minimal wind and road noise. Meanwhile, outward visibility is good thanks to rear quarter windows and a slightly raised vantage point because this is an SUV, though it doesn't really feel like an SUV from the driver's seat.
Maybe it's the assertive brake feel, maybe it's the quick, heavy-weighted steering, maybe it's the surprising amount of speed you can carry through a corner if you're feeling motivated. Whatever it is, the GV70 drives much more like a sports wagon than a proper SUV.
Considering how most people use their SUVs, I think a speedy on-road spirit is a good thing. Oh, and if you're curious, here are the fuel economy figures. Huh, it might be nice if Genesis added a hybrid to the lineup. And now, just because I love pulling Mike Danger into my videos, we're going to do a mini comparison between the Audi Q5 and the Genesis GV70.
Hey Mike, you've been driving the Audi Q5 as our camera car. Quick, what do you think of it?
I'll tell you what I think. I think the Audi Q5 is a great luxury compact SUV. The fit and finish is proper, it looks premium, and it's very comfortable, but that can be the bad part. It's too comfortable. I'd like a little bit more performance out of my vehicles, and if you want that in the Q5, you will probably have to step up to the SQ5. But as far as checking all the right boxes for a compact luxury SUV, this does just that. So comparing the GV70 to the Audi Q5, I mean, since we're on the subject of checking boxes, I'll give you three boxes I check off. Number one, the looks. This definitely checks off that box. The Audi Q5 is a bit more conservative. This is really dynamic. I mean, check out the red stitching on the inside and the outside. You're gonna definitely turn heads when you're driving down the freeway. Which leads me to box number two, the performance. The base model of the GV70 has 300 horsepower, which is more than the base model in the Audi Q5. Not only does it have more power, but it also has more weight to the steering, and the suspension isn't as cushy. It's a bit more firm, so you could do more spirited driving and feel the road up under you. The most important part is box number three, the price. The base model GV70 is $4,600 cheaper than the base price of the Audi Q5. To me, more performance, better looks, lower price, that's a win.
So if you had to choose between the Genesis GV70 and the Audi Q5 using your own money, which would it be?
You know what? I want my car to look as good as my kicks. I'm going with the GV70.
There you go. Danger has spoken.
As Mike Danger mentioned, the GV70 has a lower base price than the Q5. But at $41,000 to start, not including $1,045 in destination charges, the GV70 still comes well equipped with heated front seats, wireless phone charging, Android Auto and Apple CarPlay smartphone integration, a hands-free power liftgate, smart key access, a range of drive modes, and a fingerprint sensor that you can use to buy fuel, pay for parking, and start the vehicle, though annoyingly you'll have to use the Genesis mobile app on your phone to unlock the vehicle first.
Unlocking.
A fingerprint sensor on the driver's door screw would be cool. There's also a standard array of driver assist tech like lane keeping assist, automatic emergency braking with pedestrian detection, and full speed dynamic cruise control. On pricier renditions, you'll find ventilated front seats, Napa leather, a panoramic roof, a 360-degree camera system, a remote parking feature to dazzle your friends, a 12.3-inch 3D digital gauge cluster, ooh, an electronic rear differential with torque vectoring abilities, and an occupant alert system with ultrasonic sensors that can detect a sleeping infant breathing in the back seats. or a whiny, kicky, caffeinated journalist. Compared to similarly equipped renditions of the BMW X3, Audi Q5, and Mercedes-Benz GLC, the GV70 costs thousands less. Of course, the Genesis lacks the brand cachet of the Germans, which may or may not matter to you. More accessibly priced alternatives like the Acura RDX, Lexus NX, or Lincoln Corsair better match price-wise with the Genesis GV70.
But personally, I'm drawn to the GV70's style, lively road manners, abundant feature list, and comparatively strong value. If I were in the market for a small, fancy SUV, that's the one I'd choose. And now, more drone footage.